Everybody, so glad you could join us. Happy May! Can you believe it's May already? I hope you've been enjoying the sunshine outside. Let's get started with worship because we have a whole lot going on today. So, good afternoon! I'm awake! I'm alive! I'm excited to praise God! Woohoo! I cannot wait till next week when we get to do that in person. Yay! All right, let's get going. You know, it's been a whirlwind the last couple of weeks, and it's going to be a whirlwind as we continue through this pandemic. But you know what? Who you got? You got your parents, and you got your God. And God will bring you through all of this. Just have your hope and your trust in Him. All right, let's hit the next song. Come on, soldiers!
I'm in the Lord's army.
Yes, sir.
I'm in the Lord's army.
two songs down, one to go. But this one I wanted to have a little intro to because you have not done this song before. And I am just learning, so bear with me. So this song is the theme song to our Vacation Bible School because I have started planning and I am having so much fun. We are building a huge train and we are doing all kinds of fun gizmos and crafts and snacks. Oh my gosh, Vacation Bible School is gonna be amazing. So how do you get signed up? Well, guess what? I am opening pre-registration today. So be looking for the link in the comments because I'll be posting it live and then I'll be posting on the church page and the kids page, and we want to get you guys registered because I want to know that you are going to be there singing and dancing and enjoying Vacation Bible School with me. So registration is opening today. Yay! And this is the theme song, so I hope you love it.
We trust in you, Jesus. You're all, you're all, you're all that we need. Your power will pull us through. We're trusting in you, we're trusting in you. You give us hope and life that's forever. You make us whole and we stand together. This journey, there's no looking back. With Jesus to lead us, we're on the right track. Oh, 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 oh. Wide open spaces for wide open eyes. We're looking ahead for the next big surprise. Oh, 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 oh. We trust, we trust, we trust in you, Jesus. You're all.
So happy that you guys joined us today, and let me know if you like that song. I really hope you did. All right, so we have a lot to get to, so I'm just gonna hand it over. So have a great day, guys, and I cannot wait to see you next week. It's gonna be amazing. Love you. Mwah. Bye.
Hi, boys and girls. Our Bible lesson today happens to be about a very special baby Hebrew boy. Baby Moses was born in a time where all Egyptian soldiers were ordered to kill all the baby Hebrew boys. But Moses' mother knew she had to protect her son. And so she got a basket, a lot like this one, and put him in there and floated him down the river. Well, guess who found that baby? The princess, Pharaoh's daughter herself, found baby Moses and decided to take him and raise him as her own. Well, this was good news for Moses, because not only was he protected now, but he got to grow up in the royal household. Now, because he grew up in the royal household, he got to witness firsthand just how cruel the Egyptians were to the Israelites, to God's people. Now, one day, after Moses was grown, he witnessed an Egyptian soldier being very mean to one of the Hebrew men. He knew that it was not right, and he was filled with anger. And you know what he did? He killed that Egyptian soldier. He felt really bad about what he had done, and so bad that he actually ran away from home. After years of wandering around in the wilderness, he came across a bush one day. Now, this wasn't just any bush. No, this bush was on fire, but it was not burning up. The fire spoke to Moses, and it said, "Moses." And Moses said, "Here I am." That fire was the voice of God, and it told Moses, "Moses, take off your shoes, for you are standing on holy ground." And so Moses did what God had told him to do, and then God ordered him to go back to Egypt and to save his people from the Egyptians and from Pharaoh. And Moses argued with him and said, "God, I can't be the one that you send to stand up to Pharaoh. I don't talk well. Nobody will listen to me. And I can't go back there. I've done something really bad." And God said, "Moses, I'm sending you to do this. I will give you the strength that you need to get this job done." Obviously, Moses did not have a backpack back then, but this backpack can remind us of the journey that God was soon to take Moses on, and also the journey that he takes us on. And when God calls us to do something, you betcha that he's gonna give us the strength and the wisdom that we need to carry it out.
Hello, kids.
Hi.
Sorry couldn't see you in person, but that's the way it's got to be right now. Our story today is about Moses. And Moses had a call on his life, but he got it in an unusual way. He was out in the desert and he saw a burning bush that wasn't burning up. And whenever he approached it, God told him what he needed to do. He explained what the purpose was for his life, and he accomplished it with God's help. The thing is, every one of us has a call on our lives. In Mark 12, it says, "Love God with all your strength and everything else." And then the other one is love others, your neighbor, others. In loving them, you're going to draw them to God, because they'll see something in you that they don't have in their lives. And you can then tell them about Jesus and what he's done in your life. Yes. That's why we're called. Once you become a Christian, you're called to show his love that he's given you to others. And in that way, you're going to draw them unto God. And God wants them to be part of the whole family. He doesn't want to lose anybody. So that's an important thing for you to do. That's why whenever in children's church, I go over that prayer and I ask everybody to say that the sinner's prayer. Not because I want to do it every time, but because I want it instilled in you so that you can take and lead them in that sinner's prayer if they ask. And that way you'll be prepared. So our lesson today, go ahead, honey. Our PowerPoint.
God sends me to be his messenger. That's me and you. Both.
So do what God lays on your heart to do, to share his love with others. and God will bless you for it. We'll see you soon in the regular church.
What's your name?
I'm Yvonne.
And I'm Chuck.
And we love you.
Bye-bye.
This is a humorous retelling of the familiar Bible story to show that anyone can be used by God regardless of weakness, self-doubt, and excuses.
How's it going there, Betsy?
Moses. 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 Moses.
Yes?
Do not walk any closer. Remove your sandals, for I am the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and I am...
A burning bush.
Yes, well, that too. I have heard the cries of my people in the land of Egypt. I will set them free.
Huh? You know, I was just thinking the exact same thing. The way they're treating those poor Israelites is just wrong. In fact, the other day I was thinking of petitioning the Philistines to see if they could get an army to help.
I will be sending you.
What? 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 Do I look like one of the patriarchs? You want me to march into the heart of the Egyptian Empire? The Egyptian heart. We own the entire known world and then some empire. And just tell them to release the Israelites.
Exactly. You will say, Pharaoh, let my people go.
Hey, that's kind of catchy. Let my people go. Yeah, I like it. Now this is crazy. I'm crazy. Wait a minute. If this is, and this is a big if I were to go, who am I even gonna say has sent me? I can't just walk in and say, hey Pharaoh, on the authority of this giant burning bush I found and stumbled across on the side of Mount Horeb, I want you to let all your slaves go.
Tell them I am has sent you.
Great. Just great. The God of the Hebrews who chooses to call himself I Am has sent me to fight the upper and lower kingdoms of Egypt. Okay, let's just continue to play this little game. Let's just say I go and then, never mind. It's nothing.
Moses?
Yes. Well, what if they don't believe me?
I will give them signs.
A giant star in the sky?
No.
How about the raising of the dead?
No.
You're gonna walk on the water?
No.
You're gonna walk through the furnace?
No.
I got it. How about...
I will turn your staff into a snake.
How about you turn my staff into a snake? Can we have any plagues like locusts or frogs and such?
We'll see. Now go forth and let my people...
Wait. Let's say you have convinced me to go. There's just one more thing.
Yes?
I really just can't talk. I'm a horrible speaker. I need to have notes and read from them and gosh, I'm illiterate. I can't read, and there's like a stutter problem that just kind of, and go.
I am the inventor of speech. I can take away the voice, then I can give the voice. I am the creator of language and the poet of life. I am.
That's perfectly good and all, but can't you send someone else? I mean, how about Job? I hear he's blameless and upright, and he fears God and shuns evil, and I'm sure he can speak for you.
He's a little busy right now, sitting in dust and ashes.
Oh, goody. Then how about Jethro? He's got really good leadership skills. I'm sure he's good at leading people and telling Pharaoh to let your people go.
No, I will send your brother Aaron to meet you.
I have a brother. This is getting better. And
Moses?
Right?
Off to start an epic. I think I will call it Exodus.
It has a nice sound to it. Hey, are you, you sure you've got the right guy? Can you actually use me?
Yes, Moses. I can use anybody. Even you. Now go and free my people.
Oh.
Just as God called Moses for a specific job, God calls people today. He calls us to share the good news of his son, Jesus, with the people around us. God calls people whenever and however he chooses.
Thanks again for joining us today. We hope you had fun. Let us know in the comments what your favorite part was, and make sure to register for Vacation Bible School. We cannot wait to see you in person next week. All right. Well, have a good week, guys. Love you. Be blessed. Mwah. Bye.